expecting me to talk about, to be writing about the last 2 years and our past experiences with, you know, drugs and having a new child and all the press coming down on us and stuff like that. I decided to use experiences from books and other stories instead of even dealing with my life, you know. I mean, there's a little bit of my life, personal things in it, but for the most part, it's just, it's very unpersonal, you know, impersonal, you know. Mm-hmm. And I think that'll be a surprise to a lot of people. The general consensus was that the album may not sell as much, and so they were concerned with that, you know. But they never ever once put any pressure on us. They just basically told us their feelings and their thoughts of what they thought of the record, you know. Most people don't like the record, you know. A lot of my friends don't even like the record.
Oh,
but,
yeah
but
do you like the record?
I love it. I think it's great. Chris and Dave and I, All three of us are totally excited about it. We've achieved exactly what we've been wanting to achieve for the last two records. This is the sound that we've had in our heads that has never been able to transfer. About my past drug use. I can put the blame on that kind of influence, but it's a mixture of, you know, rock and roll in general, you know, the Keith Richards thing and Iggy Pop and all those other people that did drugs. I just thought it was just one of those things that you do, you know, to relieve the pain. But, you know, as I expected, before I started doing heroin, I realized that I knew it at the beginning that it would become just as boring as marijuana does, you know. Like all drugs, after a few months, it's just as boring as, you know, breathing air, you know. So, I just don't want to try. I've always lied about it because I didn't want to influence anybody, you know. I didn't want anyone to even consider the thought of doing drugs because it's really stupid. There's nothing more embarrassing than a group of people walking up to you and shaking and clamoring and you know and praising you like you're some kind of fucking god or something. It's embarrassing.
There's so many bands in Seattle now. Seattle is the new Los Angeles, you know, and that's kind of upsetting because Seattle was a city that, it was a clean city, and it was a small city, and there was no traffic, and there was no air pollution, and it was something really great that a lot of people were attracted to, so they moved there, and, you know, the more people that moved to the city, the bigger and worse the city gets.
I was a big heavy metal fan for years in junior high school, and I have nothing against heavy metal fans at all, you know, except for, you know, some of the, you know, for the most part, most heavy metal has always been pretty sexist, so, you know, there are a lot of areas in it that I don't agree with, but that's no reason to exclude a person from, you know, having the opportunity to listen to your music. It might be nice to eventually start playing acoustic guitars and be thought of as a singer and a songwriter rather than a grunge rocker, you know, because then I might be able to take advantage of that when I'm older and sit down on a chair and play acoustic guitar like Johnny Cash or something, you know, and it won't be a big joke, but who knows. play live, we lack a lot of things because I have to concentrate on so many different areas at once. You know, I've always lacked in any kind of participation or any kind of feelings with the audience. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I can never really, because I'm concentrated on my guitar and I have to remember the lyrics and I have to remember to push these little buttons down on my fuzz pedals and stuff. And I have to sing and all this stuff, it just confuses me. I can't chew gum and walk at the same time, so I'm expected to do like six things at once. And so just adding another guitar player is totally a relief. It just really helps. It's great. And we got this guy, Pat Smear, who's in the Germs. The pleasure I get out of it is knowing that many people like the music, you know. But I was validated beyond any expectations when we were playing in clubs, you know. Just to have that many people, just to have 50 or 100 people tell you that they like your music is fine enough with me, you know. So I've never been afraid of any kind of failure. We like to change with every song. Like every song, I'll twiddle my knobs and turn them into a different sound. So I just don't like to repeat things. Should I be? Passive aggressive in a way, you know. We don't confront one another if we're pissed off at each other. We just let the other person know that we're bothered by something that they've said, and then just forget about it. You know, it's really the only way to work with somebody. None of us have really that aggressive of personalities. Really, we don't. We're all pretty much the same kind of people, you know. So. Mm-hmm. We started as friends, and I can't see anything getting in the way to stop us from being friends. To tell you the truth, I would rather just quit my band and join Hole, you know? But only because when I have played music with them, there's a level of connection that's a little bit higher than with anyone else that I've ever played with. It's amazing. It's something that's totally satisfying for Courtney and I, but completely unrealistic because we're already so intertwined with each other, and, you know, everyone doesn't even, most people don't even think of the band Nirvana anymore. They think of Kurt and Courtney, you know, and it's just too much. It gets in the way. People would overlook the music and look into other things, you know, and it just wouldn't be taken seriously enough. So I'd like to someday, but as of now, I couldn't see anything for the next 5 years or so. We still jam together every once in a while. It's a sad situation. I really wish we could just join bands, you know.